Actually, I'm a little foggy headed because I normally don't do a show. It's not that I can't, but I normally don't do a show this early. But I thought I want to catch the people on my beloved brethren and sister and hoods out there, hoods out there on the East Coast, because I don't know. My people tell me there's a lot of my boomers out there on the East Coast. So the earlier I do it back here in the Midwest, chances are I can get a fairly good response from the boomers. This is Captain Boomer Podcast coming to you live from the beautiful Twin Cities area, where we are on deck for another 70 degree plus day, I guess. So yeah. So you big crybabies out there, oh, we had snow and it was cold last week. Eh, shut the hell up. This is Minnesota, you know. If you want boring, well, I shouldn't say boring weather. I mean, you know, certainly not going to be boring weather in Florida, although the temperature's damn near all the same year-round. But you get a little bit of extra water at times that you really don't need. also, the New Orleans. Yeah, they don't need that extra water. Anyway, today's show is entitled, It's Political D-Day. Yes, it is. And I gotta go find my, It's Political D-Day. Yes, it is. Yeah. Did you guys get out and vote? Anyway, like I said, to me, it personally, it's getting so bad, and I don't give a shit how you voted. That's your damn business. I voted for Trump. I just like to, I don't know. One of my main reasons is because, boy, I don't know. But guys, let's put things into perspective. It's supposed to be, supposedly, it's billed as the most important and crucial presidential election in the history of presidential elections. That's number one. Okay, number two, they're also saying, here we go. Well, what's going on here? Come on, buddy. Hey, come on. Damn it. Don't make me look bad again. I mean, okay. That's all I do is make myself look bad. Okay, come on. Here we go. Okay, not only is it billed as the most important presidential election in the history of this country, but at the same time, if I'm not mistaken, the guy a lot of people, you know, Joey Sleepy Joe, don't know where I am half the time, Biden, he, if I'm not mistaken, is the oldest president. He would be the oldest president at, what, 77? Now, boy, I don't know, and Sleepy Joe has a hard time remembering where the hell he is as it is. And to hand over the reins to somebody that's, I don't know, that's all I'm going to say about that. And you Biden supporters, I'm not going to tell you where I live, but it's going to get nasty. It's going to get nasty. That's how pathetic this country has become overall. It's not just about Donnie. It's not just about Donnie. It's about our whole moral fiber, our whole way we look at life now, and how with such disregard. Donnie didn't create any of that. You know, this stuff's been building up for years. The stupidity, the greed, the ignorance, the violence, the, you know, where life has no meaning. That didn't create anything that would make a person's life less valuable. We did that on our own. You know, it's just so. Anyway, at least I got my beloved Laurel Hardy and Little Rascals music, and that keeps me just fine. And well, besides my VA medications, that just fine. I'll be doing just fine. And my 12 cups of coffee in the morning. Oh yeah, yeah, we're high hootin' and rootin' tootin'. You betcha now, yeah. Oh, that's good coffee. Anyway, well, there it is. Yeah, it is. It's definitely the D-Day of our political system. And so far, I guess it's in most of the states, not most. I guess there's down to about 4 or 5 key states which could go either way. So that's where we're heading. And this whole political system, I don't know. You know, I don't. If Joey gets in, I hope he does one thing important. I think the whole whole voting system has to be redone, restructured from top to bottom. It is pathetic. You count him. We didn't count this yet. Oh, wait a minute. They're going to be late. Oh, wait a minute. We can't count these votes. Oh, wait a minute. We got to stop the voting here. Oh, we got to come over here. This line here. You got to count this one, but not this one. Overseas ballots. It's just ridiculous. It's just such a sham. And I would be a bit surprised if some of these other countries, especially in Europe and stuff, you don't hear about those people having these huge problems. And on top of it, there might even be some violence if certain people don't, if a certain person doesn't get elected, you know. Geez, what the hell kind of message are we sending to the rest of the world? You know? Anyway, yeah. You betcha. I would like this, what's this? Oh yeah, you guys, this is out to my brothers out there. You know who you are, brothers. You boo-boo dinky down boys out there, my dinky down brothers. Okay, did you shit, shower, and shave this morning, guys? Yeah, get out there. You gotta shit, shower, and shave. Yeah, you gotta shit, shower, and shave.
That was easy.
It is. It's easy. If you guys are like me, I'm 70 and a half. Well, I'll tell you, not that many years ago, when I woke up in the morning, I could jump right out of bed. Spring right out of bed, no problem. Now, man, I'm telling you, when I wake up, it's like I'm still in a daze or a half dream, and I just want to lay there, you know? The body physically doesn't want to say, hey, come on, let's get out of bed. And I'll lay you know, it's weird. I really don't like that feeling, and I guess I don't know what to say. It's just part of us getting old, right, guys? With all the creaks and cracks and pops and bangs and all sorts of crap that we've got going on with our bodies at this stage in our life. But anyway, we can just keep plugging on because we're boomers, the best damn generation ever. Chew damn right on that. No doubt about that. We are the best generation. You betcha. Yeah. Yep, you betcha. And anyways, to the people on the East Coast, good morning to you guys. Thank you for checking in. I got to give another big shout out to the country of Brazil. Brazil has checked in with me. I've got 4 different villages, towns, whatever you want to call them. Rio de Janeiro, that's not a town. Or a village. That is a huge city in Brazil. Rio de Janeiro did check in with the old captain. And boy, anybody who does check in with the old captain, it's greatly too appreciated. Trust me, I don't take a second of anybody listening to my crapola. You know, because let's face it, guys, as far as a podcaster goes, I've got a lot of work to do, and I admit that. But I'm not after anybody's favoritism. This is a hobby of mine that I chose to do about 4 years ago, and I'm going to do it as long as I can. And hope to have some fun with my my fellow boomers out there. And so that's what this is all about. And we just keep on plugging away. We're going to be playing some tunes here, as we usually do. And like I said, I want to give a big shout out to the East Coast out there. Thank you, guys. You know who you are. We're talking about Maine, Massachusetts, Connecticut, Vermont. You guys up there. Because supposedly my people told me I don't have any people. It's just me. Anyway, who want to associate with this shit, huh? But I did my research, and the greater population of us boomers are in the New England states. Yes, so that's why this program is semi-dedicated to the New Englanders out there. I hope you guys, because, hey, this wasn't my idea, okay, as far as, it was my idea to do this, but I didn't set this up. So, I'm just a messenger, sir, so don't shoot me, okay, guys? It's just that Google and those guys says that the majority of boomers, regardless of where you live, the majority of us are up before 6 o'clock in the morning. Yeah, and I believe it. I believe, on average, I'm up at 5:30, you know. Sometimes you even get up at 4, whatever. It's not right or wrong. It's just the way it is. You know, I a lot of times, at our age, we toss and turn, and I got a lot of shit rattling around up in the old brainstorm noggin, and I just got to get up and write it down or try to remember it. So that's why I sometimes just get out of bed and I write it down, and I save it either for a show or something, and I try to get a little song list going of what I'm going to play and stuff like that. Oh yeah, we got. Oh, and thank you, Tumar Portugal. Tumar Portugal checked in here about 3-4 days ago. And, I was feeling kind of down and out last week because I only had 3 cities checked in with me. And that's pathetic is what it is, though. But anyway, I thanks to you guys out there. I appreciate it. The old captain, I got 10 cities in the last 3 days to check in with Captain Boomer. And God bless all of you guys. And be safe out there. Wear your mask, please, guys. I'm telling you, that's a whole nother topic. This 2020 can kiss, as far as I'm concerned, can kiss all of the whole planet. The year 2020 can kiss our ass. Kiss our ass. It's pathetic here. I'm gonna fart on you. There you go, 2020. Crazy. Anyway, hey. Oh yeah, this is all to the hot babes out there. Oh, to the hot boomer babes. How you doing, boomer babes? Yeah, I'm gonna throw you a sloppy kiss too. How do you like them apples, huh? Yeah, you ain't gonna get that on any other program, I'll tell you that. Oh, yes, indeed. Yeah. Anyway. Oh, yeah. Old people's sounds. I'm going to have a little segment on. Ben, I'm telling you. Well, as we get older, man, I'm telling you, we're putting out some weird sounds. I don't know if you've noticed it or not, but, man, I've noticed it with the wife and even myself. Man, I'm telling you, like you're falling asleep or just taking a little snooze or a nap or something, and all of a sudden I wake myself up, I heard this really strange noise, and you come to find out it's yourself. Oh, man, I'm serious. It's kind of spooky in a way. You betcha. And it's kind of cuckoo, too.